It seems the US Navy is looking to augment the anti-ship capabilities of the Arleigh Burke-class guided missile destroyer. During their arrival to Honolulu for Exercise Rim of the Pacific, or RIMPAC, 2024, the Arleigh Burke-class guided missile destroyer USS Fitzgerald, DDG 66, was photographed with Naval Strike Missile, NSM, box launchers. This is an interesting development. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the probable addition of Naval Strike Missile on Arleigh Burke warships makes sense. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Arleigh Burke destroyers, specifically the Flight 1 and Flight 2 destroyers, have two deck-mounted Mark 141 Harpoon anti-ship missile launcher. Harpoon is an over-the-horizon anti-ship missile manufactured by Boeing Defense, Space, and Security. Initially developed in the 1970s, it's seen many upgrades over the years. The Harpoon Block 2 was developed to offer an expanded engagement envelope, enhanced resistance to electronic countermeasures, and improved targeting. The Block 2 missile provides the Harpoon with a literal water anti-ship capability. The major system components of the Harpoon Block 2 missile include a booster, warhead, guidance, and command system. It has the capability to reach targets at a distance of 80 miles or 130 kilometers and has a subsonic speed of Mach 0.7. The low speed and profile make it relatively easy to intercept. It's essentially an aging weapon. The second option is the use of an SM-6 missile, which can be launched from Mark 41 VLS cells. It was designed for extended-range anti-air warfare (ERAAW) purposes providing capability, but can be used as a high-speed anti-ship missile. Its high-velocity and quasi-ballistic missile mode of attack makes it difficult to defend against and defeat. The missile uses the airframe of the earlier SM-2ER Block 4 RIM 156A missile and some targeting elements from AIM 120C AMRAAM. It can discriminate targets using its dual-mode seeker, with the semi-active seeker relying on a ship-based illuminator to highlight the target, and the active seeker having the missile itself send out an electromagnetic signal. SM-6 has a max speed of Mach 3.5, a range of 230 miles or 370 kilometers, and a 140 pound or 64 kilogram blast fragmentation warhead. The small warhead is an issue, especially when used against a large surface combatant. The third option is the Block 5A or Maritime Strike Tomahawk, which can also be fired from Mark 41 VLS cells. It has a new seeker capable of hitting a moving target, so it could be used to target a rival's surface combatants. The target information in the variant could be updated in flight. The warhead is geared towards destroying enemy warships. It has subsonic speed and has a long range of 1,000 miles or 1,600 kilometers. It's to be noted here that while SM-6 and Maritime Strike Tomahawk are better options, they take up multi-weapon capable Mark 41 VLS cells, unlike the Harpoon. The NSM is the upgrade of Kongsberg's Penguin short to medium range anti-ship guided missile. The state-of-the-art design and use of composite materials are meant to give the missile sophisticated stealth capabilities. The missile has a high subsonic speed of Mach 0.93 at a range of up to 250 kilometers, or 160 miles, depending on the variant and flight profile. NSM is designed for littoral waters, or brown water, as well as for open sea, green and blue water scenarios. The usage of a high-strength titanium alloy blast fragmentation warhead from TDW is in line with the modern lightweight design and features high destructive power. Warhead initiation is by a void-sensing, programmable, intelligent multi-purpose fuse designed to optimize effect against hard targets. Like its Penguin predecessor, NSM is able to fly over and around landmasses, travel in sea-skim mode, and then make random maneuvers in the terminal phase, making it harder to stop by enemy countermeasures. The target selection technology provides NSM with a capacity for independent detection, recognition, and discrimination of targets at sea or on the coast. This is possible by the combination of an imaging infrared, or IIR, seeker and an onboard target database. NSM is able to navigate by GPS, inertial or terrain reference systems. After being launched into the air by a solid rocket booster, which is jettisoned upon burning out, the missile is propelled to its target by a turbojet sustainer engine, leaving the 125 kilogram or 275 pounds multi-purpose blast fragmentation warhead to do its work, which in case of a ship target means impacting the ship at or near the waterline. NSM has a high probability of impact. While developed by Kongsberg, it's now sold in partnership with Raytheon. It can be fired through a proprietary canister launcher. The current plans of the U.S. Navy include equipping both Independence and Freedom-class littoral combat ships, as well as the new Constellation-class frigates with the NSM. However, U.S. Navy budget documents have not indicated any intention to equip Arleigh Burke-class destroyers with this missile. But the USS Fitzgerald photo shows that some thinking is going on regarding this. It's unclear to what extent the NSM is integrated aboard the USS Fitzgerald. Full integration would involve connecting the missiles to the Aegis Combat Management System, a complex process requiring extensive testing and integration work, which takes significant time. A more likely scenario is that the launchers are deployed as a standalone system controlled by a dedicated computer or console that does not communicate with the Aegis system. In any case, the addition of this naval strike missile would be a very logical step and add a lot of flexibility since it will free up some Mark 41 cells for roles other than anti-ship missions. It remains to be seen how things pan out in the coming days.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.